Blackstone presents The Roof Over Our Heads by Nicole Kronzer. This book is read by Graham Halstead. For Bethany and Kristen, my sisters and permanent friends. Chapter 1. 3 items remained on my to-do list: check-in costumes, finish prepping dinner, and empty buckets in the attic. Jade arriving 4 hours early was not on my list. It was not on anyone's list. Yet here she was. "Why?" I asked when I pulled open the front doors and found Jade standing on the carriage step in jeans and a white tank top, a small suitcase at her feet. "That's no way to greet someone donating 2 weeks of her life to help out your family, asshat," she said. She looked good in that tank top. Her dark skin, bronze was the word she always used to describe it, all glowy now that it was June. Her curly hair pulled back from her face, the other parts of her body doing their other parts things. Not that I noticed, or cared. 5 years ago, in 6th grade, when Jade learned that I, a white guy, had one white mom, one black mom, and 2 biracial brothers, she double high-fived me. Right in the middle of math class. Instead of dividing fractions that day, she told me about her white parents, and we exchanged stories the whole hour and became friends. But a lot had changed since then. I forced my eyes to stay trained on hers. "My family does not need you here until 5. She raised an eyebrow. "I thought you might want help setting up." "No, thank you." "But," our argument paused as a blue Honda Civic pulled into the circular drive. Whoever it was hadn't been here before. I could tell because of how slowly they were approaching the house. Gaping, probably, unsure if number 4 Summit Avenue really meant this 5-story red sandstone mansion. It did. Smiling, I sidestepped Jade and jogged down the steps. Unless someone had ordered food, this person was here to deliver costumes, including mine. A bewildered-looking woman in her 40s stepped out of the car. "Is this... probably?" She laughed a little. "I'm supposed to be delivering costumes from Beauregard Costume Rental." "Nice. Kathy and Mandy send you?" "Yes. I'm..." "New," I finished. "Oh, God, that obvious?" I laughed. "No worries, you've come to the right place." "I'm Jade," Jade inserted herself. "And this is Finn." I rolled my eyes at Jade as the woman keyed open her trunk, revealing a mountain of long dresses and suits on hangers enclosed in plastic dry cleaning bags. "Finn," Jade warned me as I piled the bags high over my arm. "Victorian costumes are really heavy." I added 3 more to my stack. "Good thing I'm really strong." In her defense, I didn't used to be. But like I said, a lot had changed. "What is this place?" the costume deliverer asked, following us under the carriage porch and up the steps. I glanced at Jade and adjusted the costumes I was holding so I could open one of the front doors, but didn't respond right away. There was the easy answer: the Jorgensen house. Originally built by Swedish lumber and railroad baron Carl Jorgensen in 1891 for his family, consisting of his wife Anna and their 8 daughters. But even the easy answer led to more questions. Who owned it now? Who was I? And the one this person was sure to add: why did we need all these costumes? It was a long story, and a complicated one, and I didn't feel like going into it with a stranger. Jade piped up, "Let's just hang the costumes on that Z-rack." Back in 6th grade, when we were best friends, I would have flashed Jade a grateful smile, but we weren't in 6th grade anymore. Kathy and Mandy's new hire shrugged and looped the hangers over the rolling rack I'd set up in the reception room. "Whoops, be careful of the plaster."
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.